It started when aviation pioneer Glenn Curtiss sold the Navy its first plane. The Navy stipulated that he would train one naval aviator as part of the deal. After mechanical malfunction forced a young sailor into an impromptu solo in the Grasshopper, Glenn Curtiss knew he had his man. That man was Lieutenant J.G. Spuds Ellison. Ellison reported to Mr. Curtiss in December 1911 and spent over a year training in aeronautical engineering and theory, mechanics, and pilotage. His flight training reached its pinnacle with a solo cross-country flight in the Curtiss A1 Triad. So it was, in April 1913, Glenn Curtiss issued the first Naval Aviator Certificate, making Theodore G. Ellison Naval Aviator Number 1. It was in 1911 the Navy started to take aviation to sea. There had been several catapult launches of the Curtiss biplanes off of ships, but there was no way to recover them. So in January 1911, they placed a wooden deck on the aft section of the battleship Pennsylvania. On January 18, 1911, Eugene Ely flew a Curtiss biplane onto Pennsylvania, making the first arrested landing ever on a ship, and the concept was proven. So the Navy took the Collier USS Jupiter and had her converted. And on March 20th, 1922, she was recommissioned CB-1 USS Langley, and Carrier Aviation was born. But we had a lot to learn. But learn we did, and the first flat top, CB-1, USS Langley, was our teacher. In 1923, the Navy decided they needed a central headquarters for training their naval aviators. They settled on a Navy yard at Pensacola, Florida. It was warm, so the waters wouldn't freeze. It had fair winds and wasn't on the coastlines where prying eyes could watch. By World War II, Naval Air Station had over a dozen surrounding fields. Few of those remain, and Chevalier has since been replaced by Sherman Field on the west end of the base. Soffley Field is now known as the outlying field at Soffley, and it's for practice and emergencies. Porter Station has since been bisected by Chiefs Way, and is home to Center for Information Dominance, the Naval Hospital, and Shopping Mall. Seaplane ramps are now boat ramps, and Bronson Field is known as Blue Angel Recreation Park. Whiting remains holding primary and intermediate helicopter training squadrons. but those that would be an aviator still come, beginning their indoctrination surrounded by white sands and clear water, where the Blue Angels make their home, where future naval flight officers train, where legendary aircraft and history come alive.